One big workshop. Every day we're tested on every level and we all react and respond in different ways. Nothing will ever hit you as hard as life does. One of my most important philosophies is that to be able to react positively and manage whatever it is life throws at us, and be it in a professional sporting environment, be it in a business environment, even in our own private life, is that we have to understand who we are. We have to understand ourselves, and most important of all, we have to understand how our mind works.
This next challenge is going to all be about mental strength.
If you're in a role that requires leadership and you're leading a team, it's absolutely imperative that you learn and are able to lead and guide yourself before you can successfully lead and guide other people. And once you understand yourself better and why you react to certain things, the power that you can have is absolutely immense. The mind is the most powerful tool that you have. And more often than not, you allow the mind to affect you in a negative way. And it takes absolutely the same amount of effort to think about something positively as it does to think about something negatively. So imagine how confident and powerful you could be if you can turn that round so that your mind does work in a positive way for you.
You did it, take the positive out of it. You went through hell and you came through hell and you both stood here, okay? That's what we wanted to see. You didn't give up.
The simplicity of where this originates from is the conflict that the mind has between truth and lies. The result of believing in the truth, of course, is the positive outcome, but it's believing in the lies that has a negative outcome that is often through suffering. The first lie we normally believe in is the I am not. I am not good enough. I am not perfect. I am not able to.
It's a bit of a shame what we've just seen, actually, is Soren refusing to go again. And Soren really is just literally almost just held a white flag up and saying, I'm not going to win the competition anymore.
The easiest way to understand the mind is to split it into three different sections. Conscious, which is the rational and factual part of us. Subconscious, and this contains all the information stored since the day we were born. Then there's the inner voice. This also includes our ego, and this is the part that projects that it knows absolutely everything. The inner voice is not always negative. It also protects us, and it can be positive for us. The inner voice is that voice we hear in our minds. It's like a wild horse taking us where it wants to go. However, once you tame the horse, you can guide the horse. And by doing that, you can then manage where you want to go. And learning to manage it is the challenge that we all have to overcome. And that's where my work comes in, helping people to be the best that they can be. Once you understand yourself and your character and how your mind works, and you are able to manage the inner voice, is then about following four simple principles. Always be true to your word. Don't take things personally. Don't make assumptions. And always do your best. And the power of mastering this will change your life.